Guys, good morning. Good morning. Woo! We have made it to Friday, y'all. It is Friday here in the heart of the Arkansas Delta. It is time to grab your coffee, grab your Bibles, grab your journals, and pull up a chair. It is time to kickstart your day. Get that weekend off rolling right, and let's enjoy the chat this morning. So good to see each of you this morning. When you get in, please say hello. Let me know that you're going to hang out with the pastor this morning as we just chit-chat a few things that's going on around us, around the country. And then, guys, we are wrapping up a very powerful chapter 7 in the book of 2 Samuel. So come on in, y'all, and let's get this thing going today, y'all. Come on in here. It is it's a great day. It is a great day. It's cool. It's like 70 degrees outside. It is so cool. It is cloudy. It's overcast. There is storms in the state, or should I just say rain in the state? I've not heard anything about storms, but there is rain in the state, and it looks like it is going to pass just north of us. So we might see some pop-ups later today. I don't know, but there are some here. Matter of fact, I am currently looking at the weather radar. And there's some things floating, look like it's over around Batesville. I think that's about right. Let me pull that up a little tight. No, it's not quite into Batesville yet. Mm-mm, no, it's around Clinton, about to roll into Heber and to Mountain View. So that's where the rain is. Looks like it is rolling due northeast. So I don't think we're going to see it, but who knows? Guys, it is a glorious day in the hood. I mean, glorious day. Even as I look out right now, it looks like the sun's trying to pop through. So praise the Lord for that. Guys, come on in. Say hello. Let me know what you're doing. Let me know what's going on this weekend with y'all. And then, guys, go ahead and hit that share button. You know what I'm saying. Hit the share button. Let's get her out there. Get her done, y'all. Let's get her done. That's exactly what I'm trying to do. Get some things popped over to my Facebook wall. And I'm going to put it over in a couple other places today as well. So come on in. We would love to see you as we got all kinds of things to chit-chat about today. I mean, there is all kinds of things taking place. We want to make sure that we don't miss a thing today as we get her talking about. So come on out. Miss Denise says that the sun is out at the church. Miss Denise and Gloria, ladies, there are there at the church campus. They are cleaning the church campus, getting us ready for Sunday morning services, and we just say a huge thank you for that. We're all clean. We're all sanitized. Everything is all well and good for your safety, and we value your safety, folks. We value it tremendously, and so make no worries, okay? Everything at our place is laid down, it is cleaned, it is sanitized, and you know, we've got room for you to spread out and social distance, so there should be no reason not to come to church. We'd love to have you. Love to have you, so come on in, y'all, and get ready to have a good day on Sunday. We definitely want to see you there on the campus on Sunday. Guys, come on in. I am almost through clickety-click, and hopefully I get over and do some visiting. I'm definitely looking forward to that. Like I said, we got all kinds of things happening that we want to chit-chat about. And talk about, see what's going on, and all of that good stuff. I'm almost there, y'all, almost. It just takes a few extra clicks. You know, as you can only go as fast as your internet will let you. And, you know, every now and then, it works about as slow as I do. And so, always keeps me on my toes. Let me see here. I think I'm about there. I'll do that, and I will do that, and I think I'm going to be in the building. I am here. I am here. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We are in. We are in. Let me see here. Who all is here? Who all is here? Brian Ponder, good morning. Let's see, Brian, your surgery's a week from today, buddy. Don't like much. You're a week out. Let's see here. Miss Sandy is here. Good morning, Sandy. Glad you are here. Miss Sandy, how's things up on your hill this morning? What's going on with you? Let's see. Tommy Gray, you in the building. Hey, brother, y'all camping this weekend? Y'all out on a lake somewhere? Holler at me. I've been miss seeing you and Sandy. Woo! Wow. Sandra, I just absolutely drew a blank. I am so sorry about that. Good Lord. That is age and not near enough coffee combining right there. Good Lord. Man. What all is going on here? Let's see here. Oh, yeah, man, it is good stuff. Miss Sandy says she is house cleaning. House cleaning today. Hey, there's John Oden. John, I hadn't seen you in a minute, buddy. Glad you are here. How's things in Nashville? What's going on over in Central Tennessee today, buddy? Tell me all about it. Tell me what's going on. Man, we got lots and lots of things to chit-chat about. You got time right now to go ahead and share some things, get this out to your newsfeed, and maybe go ahead and invite some of your friends, tag them, do all kinds of good stuff before we really get started into the meat of things. We got just a lot of good things we want to talk about today. John says, all good in the Ville. That's what I'm talking about. I was in Nashville back around the middle of June. The National Southern Baptist Convention was held there in downtown, and I came over literally for one day. We drove over early that morning and spent the day and drove back. So, man, that was a long, blessed day. We had a good time, though. We parked right down by the Gibson Guitar Factory. Man, it's just great. Just great. I loved it. I loved down there. I didn't get a chance to do any sightseeing. Like I said, it was a book day of meetings and all good stuff. But first time I've been in Nashville in several years, so I enjoyed being over there. I'd love to go back and just take some time and walk around. I'm a Nashville fan. I love Nashville. Of course, I used to spend a lot of time in Nashville with my secular career, working with the country music artist. And so I was there all the time, and I hadn't been back in several years, and so I do miss it. But yeah, it was a road trip and a half, and there were eight of us, I think. We're all in a 15 passenger van. We just took a van load of preachers from over here to go over there, and so it was a great day of fellowship and fun on the ride over. But it just made for a long day. We stopped at a place in Jackson, Tennessee on the way home that day that was absolutely amazing. It was a place called Casey Jones, all based around trains. And it was the food was fabulous. It was a homemade take on a Cracker Barrel setup, if that makes any sense. You felt Cracker Barrel light going in there, but the food was not that cut and dried Cracker Barrel flavor. It was homemade flavor. Oh my word, just think about it, was great. And it was an all you could inhale food type thing. And we made it in right toward the end of the night as they were beginning to wind down, so it was quiet. And of course, we were a bunch of loud and obnoxious preachers, and we just ate till our fill. It was so good. You had catfish and you had chicken, turnip greens, real deal mashed potatoes and gravy, homemade bread, just serious food. So if you guys are over in that way, you might want to stop there. The place is called Casey Jones and it is in Jackson, Tennessee. Great, great, great stuff. Guys, let's talk about what's going on. This weekend, things going on in the country. Hello to everybody. Come on in, say hello. Let me know that you're here, and please go ahead and hit the share button when you get in. Today, this is tax-free shopping weekend in the state of Arkansas, y'all. Tax-free shopping weekend. That means anything that you buy, school supplies and stuff like that, on Saturday and Sunday is going to be tax-free. And I've also read where they are including like computers and technology. So, all kinds of stuff that are going on. You can save some money in your taxes if you need to get out and do that. So that is all this weekend. Let me mark that off. Let's see here. Alan, what you got? As of yesterday, Marion School is open. That is right, Alan. And I did some homework yesterday as well. And this morning, Marion School is open. Okay. But as of yesterday afternoon, guys, y'all ready for this? They have 830 kids or 830 people, students and teachers in quarantine. 830. I can't wrap my head around that. So 830 in quarantine in Marion schools, but they are still open. Real quick numbers from yesterday. Let me just go ahead and throw this out here. We were up in the state of Arkansas, up 2,777 cases. That's up. We had an increase of 19 people in the hospital. We had an increase of 3 additional people on ventilators, and we had 17 deaths yesterday. So that was all taking place in the state of Arkansas. And so, guys, we got school beginning to ramp up here in the next couple of weeks. So we got to pray for our teachers. We got to pray for our students, because I have a feeling we're going to see this thing absolutely take off like wildfire. So we got to be really, really careful. And speaking of the virus, U.S. Airlines has announced yesterday that they are requiring all of their U.S. employees to be vaccinated. That is a requirement in order to work for U.S. Airlines. If not, you will be terminated. So that, I believe, could be that. I know they're not the only one. That's just the ones that I've seen. And I have a feeling that is a sign of things to come. So, you know, it is here. And you know, something that I've also read, I read this morning. Let me find it. There it is. Something that I really thought would be coming was that our major universities, our colleges and universities, I felt like long time ago when the vaccination was beginning to come in, I felt like most universities would require all faculty, staff, and students to be vaccinated or not be able to attend or work there. I really thought that was coming. And we have begun to see that. Oh yeah. Hey, good morning, Mary. I see Mary coming in. Ruth Hastings, good morning, y'all. I really thought that was coming, and we have begun to see that there are schools now requiring, you know, you to be vaccinated or you can't teach there. And there's been people that's been terminated because of their refusal to be vaccinated, and there are students that are not allowed to come on campus if you're not vaccinated. In the state of North Carolina, this was this morning, okay? In the state of North Carolina, students are paying, okay? Somebody has, you had to know this was coming. Somebody is creating fake vaccination cards. Not even kidding. Fake vaccinations, okay? That, are you ready for this? These kids are paying $200 or more to get their hands on a fake vaccination card so they can go to school. Robert, but do you believe that requirement is right? No. No, I don't, Robert. I just don't. I don't. I don't think it's right at all. Now, you get into the private sector with employees, that's one thing. But on the college campus, yeah, that's a no for me, dog. It's just, But it's so bad now that kids are paying $200 to get their hands on a vaccination card just so they can go to school. And I thought that was kind of crazy. I mean, crazy, 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 crazy. Hey, let's read our Bible verse for the day. Let's read our Bible verse today. This is a humdinger, y'all. This is the one we hang our hat on. We can hang our hat on all of them, right? Romans 8:37. Y'all, you ready? Romans 8:37. Here it is. Ready? Paul says this to the church at Rome. He said, y'all, hang on to this, yet in all things. Now, I just need you to underline the word all. He does not say in most things. He does not say in some things. He says in all things, we, the believer, the church, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. Amen, amen, and amen. Yet in all things, you write it down in all things. As believers, in all things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. There is nothing that can stand in our way as a believer. We have the power of a holy God to walk and march forward. Robert, I'm not a smart man, but I know what all means. Amen. Woo! Amen. Yet it often, and let's just keep reading, y'all. This is great stuff. Y'all, if you've never read the book of Romans, it will part your hair and put gel in it. I mean, it is unbelievably good. In all things, we are more than conquerors through him. Hey, let's just back up. Verse 35. You ready? Verse 35. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Who shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? Paul says, as it is written back in Psalm 44, for your sake we are killed all day long. That's us as the believer. We are killed all day long. We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter, yet in all things. Underline that word all. In all things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am persuaded, Paul, the intellect that he is, he was the most educated being in his time. He said, for I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. And all God's children said, amen and amen. Now that is what I'm talking about, folks. That is going to get us cranking today on this Friday. That's a way to kickstart the weekend. Amen. Everybody right now, hit that heart button right there. Hit that heart button. Let's light that heart button up, y'all. This is what I'm talking about. This is the God we serve. This is the God that loves us and protects us, y'all. This is the God. In all things, we are more than conquerors. Stand on it, church. Do not allow anything, anybody, anywhere to take you off your focus of Christ. Watch, God, that's why we must focus more on people than on these cultural issues. That's right. People need to know Jesus. We've got to get the word out, y'all. Got to get the word out. That's all in Romans chapter 8. Y'all need to get on over there and spend some quality time up in that today. Hey, what else we got going on? Hey, big day in the Olympics yesterday, y'all. Big day in the Olympics. Let me get over there. We want to make sure. We talked yesterday that there were two ladies, two mothers, that were in the finals of the 400 meter that was going to be run last night, okay? One of them, Allison Phoenix, won bronze last night, okay? That is huge, all right? Now, why is it huge? Because that is Allison Felix. That is her 10th medal in Olympic competition. She is the most decorated female in women's track and field history. 10 medals. She is the equivalent of Carl Lewis. Carl Lewis is the most decorated man in track and field history. He has 10 medals. She nailed it. Nailed it. Bronze. I'm talking cleaned house. And I am so excited for her. I am so excited for the United States. As of this morning, we have won 92 medals. 32 of them are gold. Our women's beach volleyball team won gold last night. That was huge. Men's basketball qualifies for the gold medal round. Women's soccer won bronze. Y'all, skateboarding is now an Olympic sport. I just can't even. That and wall climbing, rock wall climbing. What in the world, okay? But we had someone win bronze on the last day of the first ever skateboard. Men's baseball is playing in the gold medal game. So lots and lots of things going on in the Tokyo Olympics. And they are winding that thing down, so it won't be long till they will be wrapping it up. So that is all we got there. Y'all, I don't know if you're reading this. I don't know if you are reading this, but the fires on the West Coast are still rampant. I mean, they are bad. And they are so bad. Y'all ready? They are so bad that there is one historic town in California. Greenville, California has been completely destroyed. The entire town burnt to a crisp. So, guys, we got to be praying about this. I'm telling you, we got to be laying this down. So we need to be praying for those fires out there, one entire town. Hey, on that great bit of good news, and I've read this morning. I was blown away. Target, the big box store, Target. Now, I'm just going to preface what I'm about to say by saying this. I'm not really a big Target fan. Never have been. They'll have a few good items, and I may go in and cherry pick some things, but we're just really not a Target bunch here. We're really not. But they have announced now, y'all ready for this? This is huge. They are paying 100% of their employees' college education, tuition, fees, textbooks for their employees to go to school, both for full-time and for part-time workers. And they are also paying if you are going to graduate school for their employees. 100% tuition. That is monumental, guys. Huge, huge stuff. College debt. College education debt is off the charts. And so for a company to reinvest into their employees is absolutely cutting edge stuff. Now, Walmart is wanting to do some of the same things. Now, I don't think they've made it as widespread as this. No kidding. But Chipotle, which is a phenomenal Mexican restaurant, especially in the north. I don't think there's any around here, maybe Memphis, maybe Little Rock, but it was one of our favorite places to eat when we lived in Ohio. Chipotle is doing something along this line to pay for education for their employees. And guys, this is a way for retention. This is keeping your employees there. And this is a smart move. Oh, it's a smart move by the corporations, because when you have turnover with employees, it costs thousands of dollars to replace employees. Because you've got to go through the marketing to get the people out there, the ads to get new applicants. You've got to go through the time of your HR people to go through the interviews and to hire people. Then you got to go through all of the funding of their training periods. So to pay for their education is, truthfully, folks, it's saving them lots of money. So yeah, Target paying 100% for part-time and full-time employees, even grad school, paying it all. I'm talking lock, stock, and barrel. They are paying for it. And to that, I say, praise the Lord. That's good stuff. Good stuff. Okay, let's see here. Alan said, this is National Catfish Month. Well, somebody needs to take the pastor out to get some catfish, y'all. We need to go celebrate. That's all I'm saying. We need to celebrate today, not for the month, but today is National Fresh Breath Day. I'm just going to leave that right there, y'all. National Fresh Breath. We might want to call that National, Tic Tac Day. Y'all need a Tic Tac. That's what I'm saying. Get a Tic Tac. National Fresh Breath Day. It is also National Wiggle Your Toes Day. Who comes up with this stuff? National Wiggle Your Toes Days. It is National Water Balloon Day. Now, when I was doing church camps all the time, y'all, water balloons was the bomb.com. I mean, it was rocking and rolling. I love water balloons. I'm a little bit too old for that mess now. Even when I was doing some college ministry, man, water balloons was the bomb. It was great stuff. But now, here is something y'all can hang your hat on. Everybody needs to get ready and go get one of these today. It is National Root Beer Float Day. National Root Beer Float. Now, my wife wouldn't touch root beer with a 10-foot sterilized crowbar. She says root beer tastes like Pepto-Bismol. But now she would light up a Coke float, y'all. I mean a Coke float. And so today is National Root Beer Float Day. Robert, who comes up with this? Thank you. Who in the right mind comes up with this stuff? Does somebody pay people to come up with this stuff? It is the most bizarre things I've ever seen. Now, tomorrow, y'all ready for this? Tomorrow, now since we're not going to have a chat tomorrow, I'm going to go ahead and just throw this out at you. Tomorrow, August the 7th, it is National Lighthouse Day. Now, let me just say this. In Ohio, where we live, there were a lot of lighthouses up on the coast around Lake Erie and, of course, all of the lakes up there. And there was one up there that was just absolutely stunning that, you know, we would see occasionally when we would, you know, just kind of drive around. So tomorrow's National Lighthouse Day. Miss Annie, my grandma made homemade root beer. Okay, now that's what I'm talking about, homemade root beer. There was a place in Tiffin, where we lived, in Tiffin, Ohio, that made their own root beer. Oh, my soul, it was so good. So good. And you bought it by the gallon. You could just go up there and say, I want a gallon of root beer. And they would put that dude in a jug, and you could take that home. And, you know, they were the good stuff. They put it in frosted mugs for you. That's what I'm talking about. Now, that's good stuff. Tomorrow's National Lighthouse Day. It's also National Raspberries and Cream Day. No, just no. It is National Play Outside Day. That really needs to come back. We need to kick these kids out of the house and off their technology components and say, haul your hiney out and get dirty. Go roll in the mud. Get out there. Rub some dirt in it or something. I mean, just go. You need to get outside and you need to go play. Get dirty. Okay? Amen. So amen to that. Come on, y'all. Hit that heart button. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Hit that heart button right now. Tomorrow is also... Who comes up with this? National Mustard Day. National Mustard Day. I didn't say honey mustard. I just said mustard. National Mustard Day. Every now and then, I like mustard on a hot dog or something like this. I mean, who knows? Mary Whittington needs a National Cheetos Day. That's what I'm talking about, Mary. National Cheetos Day. You're going to make me buy a bag of Cheetos and eat it in your honor the next time I go to the grocery store. I mean, I'm just going to have to do it. And I like, yeah, Robert's spot on. Miss Mary, you need to start it as a National Cheetos Day. The problem is that every day is National Cheetos Day for Miss Mary. Every day. And finally, tomorrow, it is National Purple Heart Day. National Purple Heart Day for those soldiers who have been wounded in war. And to that, I say, we thank you for your service. So if you have a loved one, a friend, a family, a relative, a coworker that has received the Purple Heart, make sure you contact them, reach out to them tomorrow. National Purple Heart Day. All of that going on. All right, guys, lots and lots of things, like I said, going on in our country, lots and lots of things happening. The Congress here in Arkansas is still debating about revoking that school mask ban. So who knows what's going to take place there. Just make sure you stay up to date on it. So let's see. Today is Friday. That means that I will see you guys again, Lord willing, on Sunday, 8:30. Coffee bar is alive and well, y'all. Come on in, grab some coffee, kick back, chit-chat, relax, and fellowship from 8:30 to 9:30 there in the fellowship area of our church campus. At 9:30, Dr. Jones is going to be leading Sunday school along with all the other classes that's going on in our church campus. Miss Mary says, you've got a new cup. Actually, no. Miss Mary, this is a cup that I have had for years. It's one of my favorite cups, to be honest with you. It's what I generally drink from throughout the day. And it says, Dad, Head Honcho, Big Wheel, Fearless Leader, Chief, Top Brass, Boss, at least when Mom's not around. Amen and amen to that. Amen and amen to that. 8:30. Come on in, grab your coffee. And if you have not been mugged yet, guys, we've still got a few of the Ridgewood cups left, or mugs. We'd love for you to get those. $5 a piece. $5. So come on in, get those. And then we want you, hey, if you've already got one, buy a couple more and give them away and invite people to church, okay? That's a great way to invite some folks to church. Y'all take Pastor Jim out for catfish. Do it today. I'm talking, my phone lines are open right now. I will take anybody's invitation to test catfish for National Catfish Month. And I'll do it again on Monday. And for the next person who wants to take me out on Tuesday, and the next person on Wednesday, and y'all, we can go out every day for every day in August. Because I can be the sampler. I can do it. And then, 10:30 on Sunday morning. Guys, worship's going to kickstart. We are ready to worship together, corporately, to come together. And then we are continuing in this unbelievable, powerful book of James. As we are continuing that study, James, where life and faith collide. It is rip-romping powerful. You don't want to miss a bit of it. And you know, I just want to let you know, I know the numbers are rising. The COVID numbers are rising. I get that. Guys, we are so sanitized in that church. We have so much room to spread out. You can social distance. I mean, you can sit in a corner by yourself and nobody will bother you. We just want to encourage you to not let that slow you down to come on into our building. We've got hand sanitizers everywhere. And if you need masks, I guarantee you we can come up with masks if you want to wear a mask. They are not required, but if you want to wear one, then wear one. No harm, no foul. Just come hang out with us on campus. We would love, love, love to have you. Love to see your sweet smiling face and to worship together corporately. And there's nothing like it, y'all. This is good, but there's nothing like it. Nothing like it. Nothing like it at all. My buddy, thanks for allowing me to troll you guys this morning. I love y'all. God bless. My main man, Mr. Robert Fellas. Y'all, say hello to my absolute best friend in the world. That is my buddy right there, Robert Fellas. Robert, you need to call me here in just a little while. We're headed over to 2 Samuel. So if y'all want to hang just a few more minutes, what, John, you got to get out. I understand. We're headed to 2 Samuel. It is unreal what is about to take place. Because yesterday, David began that prayer. Y'all remember that? We were in verse 18, and he started out to God, "Who am I, O Lord God? Who am I? What is my house that you have brought me thus far?" David laid his heart bare before the Lord yesterday. It was unbelievable. All in thanksgiving for what God had promised him that was going to do. He was going to establish the throne of David forever. And he's kept his word. He's kept his promise. Today, he is continuing in that prayer as we begin in verse 25, and we're going to wrap up the chapter. But today, as he was coming before God, literally, who am I? Today, what he's going to do is David is boldly coming before God, and he is asking that the promise that God said to be fulfilled. He's not coming arrogantly. He's not coming demanding. He's not coming self-righteously. He is claiming the promise that God has given him. And this is a lesson that we need today. The Bible is filled with promises. Do we claim those promises? Do we reach out and say, God, I am praying that this promise be fulfilled in my life? Let's read. We're in verse 25 of chapter 7. Verse 25, chapter 7. David, still in his prayer, and he says this: "Now, O Lord God, the word which you have spoken concerning your servant," still referring to himself as his servant, "the word you have spoken, the promises you've said, the word which you have spoken concerning your servant and concerning his house, establish it forever and do as you have said." Need to underline or you need to highlight that verse. In other words, I am claiming and I'm holding you. I'm believing in you to establish what you have told me you're going to do and that you are going to do as you have said. In other words, you're going to keep your word. I'm trusting in you, God, to keep your word. I'm standing on my faith, believing that what you have just said about establishing my kingdom right here on this earth, the throne of David forever, I'm holding on to it. David says, so let your name be magnified forever, saying the Lord of hosts is the God of Israel. And let the house of your servant David be established before you. For you, O Lord of hosts, God of Israel, have revealed this to your servant, saying, I will build you a house. Therefore, your servant has found it in his heart. Where's he praying from? Guys, this is not lip service. This is not a brainiac talking. This is the heart of God's man right here, laying it all out bare to him. This is where prayer has to come from, not just lip service. Man, for you, O Lord of hosts, God of Israel, have revealed this to your servant, saying, I will build you a house. Therefore, your servant has found it in his heart to pray this prayer to you. And now, O Lord God, you are God, and your words are true, and you have promised this goodness to your servant. Now, therefore, let it please you. Let it please you to bless the house of your servant, that it may continue before you forever. For you, O Lord God, have spoken it. And with your blessing, let the house of your servant be blessed forever. Church, this is where we've got to camp at. We've got to stand on this right here. We have to have the heart of the King that we're seeing right here to stand firm in our faith and to trust and to believe and to ask God to live up to His Word. It's not that we're holding Him to it. That's not it at all. It's believing that God will do what He says. Establish it forever and do as you said. Notice, this wasn't David being passive in any way. He didn't come to God and say, well, God, just do whatever you want to do. That's not it. That don't need to be the way our prayers be, okay? We cannot just come to God and say, God, I really don't care one way or the other. Just do whatever you need to do. No. Although God's word is filled with promises. David didn't go to him and say, well, you know, God, let me tell you what you need to do. Okay, it wasn't that way. This was a very bold prayer on faith and on trust. God, here is your promise. Now I trust you to fulfill it and to be faithful to your word. Y'all, are we that way in our prayers? Are we standing firm on the promises that God has given us? Are we claiming those promises that He has given us? Are we believing in our prayers that He's going to hold on to it? What are some of the promises that He's given us? Let's just look at a few, okay? Let's just look at a few of the promises that y'all, we can ask God to live up to. How about the promise for forgiveness, okay? 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Y'all, what's a promise of God? How about the promise for peace that He's given us? John 14:27. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Not let your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Are we asking God to fulfill that promise of peace in our life? How about the promise for guidance? In Psalm 32:8, I will instruct you and teach you in the way you should go. I will guide you with my eye. Are we claiming that today? How about the promise for growth, spiritual growth? We talked about that on Wednesday night. That's a process called sanctification. Philippians 1:6, he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. Guys, this can go on and on. And I'm going to close with this one. How about the promise for help? Hebrews 4, verse 16. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace of help in time of need. Guys, let us come boldly to the throne of grace and ask God to fulfill the promises. Find those promises in Scripture. This is where we get into God's Word, and we know what those promises are. We don't hope that He has a promise, but we know what His promises are, and we can stand on those, and we ask God to fulfill those. And it is a prayer from the heart. It's not from a book of prayers. It's not from a book of poems. It is not from your head. It is not from your mouth, as I've already said. It comes from the right place, the only place that prayer should originate, and that it comes from the heart. And pray that prayer, okay? Pray it. Pray that prayer. Don't just think about it. Pray that prayer. Lay it out there before God. Claim those promises. Y'all, amen. What a word that we have on this Friday. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. It doesn't get any better than that on this Friday. Oh, guys, I love y'all so much. Thanks for hanging out with me each morning. I love our time together. I love our chit-chat. I love our laughter. I love our fun. But I love diving deeper into God's Word and to seeing what God's Word has for us and what we can do and what we're missing, y'all. Don't miss this. There are promises that God is laying out before us right now. It's all in His Word. It's not hidden. It's all right there. Lay it out there. God, I'm asking you to just to hold true to your promise. Speak to us, oh God. Fulfill those promises. Guys, if you get out anytime today, I want to encourage you to get on out and be safe. Enjoy the coolness of this day. It is gorgeous out there. We might have a little rain a little later on. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Plan on being in church with us on Sunday. Please make sure that you're coming. Ring people's phones loose. Invite them to church. Tell them we want to see their face. But most importantly, if you see anybody, tell them about Jesus. I love you guys. Have a great weekend. I'll see you Sunday morning.